In this video, we'll be talking about how to create connection to your audience, to your target customer of your Amazon brand. When you sell Amazon products on your Amazon listing, you want people to connect to what you do. And you will get today a few ideas how you can create content which connects to your audience. And I think it's not so difficult to create this one, this type of content. So I would like to invite here my guest, Sacha Gorelik. She runs a copywriting service.
Hi, correct. Sasha. Nice to be here again. It's always fun.
Yeah. So please tell us more what you do, and then we will jump to the slides.
So I have been working with Amazon sellers and e-commerce store owners for like about 6 years now, doing Amazon listings, website content, brand messaging, basically all the fun, wordy stuff that people need for their business. And also just helping them a lot with strategy as well. Like what we're going to be talking about today is really, you know, creating a more authentic brand to build up loyalty and everything else. So, we can jump right in if you want.
No, I don't want.
Not yet.
I want to first remind to everyone who is watching, if you will have questions about the content you hear, use the live chat box to enter your questions live, if you're watching live, so Sasha can answer now. If you are watching the recording, you will find the comment section below in the description. And as always, don't forget to like and subscribe our videos to show you more videos in the future. So we're ready with your presentation. And what we will be talking today from your words, from your...
Oh, from my words? So we're going to be talking about user-generated content. And I think I'm going to say a few interesting things that people might not be necessarily aware of, number one. And number two, also just some strategies how you can really connect with your customers properly in your communication. And we'll see in the presentation.
Perfect. Let's do it.
All right. Okay. Can you see my screen?
Yes.
Okay, great. So let's get started. So I am going to be talking about how you can sell more products with more authenticity. So before we get started, we have to do the boring stuff, which is, this has come straight from Amazon. This is what they tell you, that you're not allowed to have any quotes or attributions to individual customers or other private figures. However, many thousands of sellers are using UGC content. So this basically means that you shouldn't really like write a specific name of somebody or something like that. You can have like endorsements if you have celebrities, but like they have to be well-known people, public figures. Or if like you have some kind of, if you've won an award or something like that, it really needs to be within date and you need to cite like the publication that you were featured in. So those are just some of the boring rules to start with. Okay, so now I'm going to talk about like connecting with your customers before we actually jump into the UGC stuff, because I think it's important that, everyone's heard this term being thrown around, UGC, UGC, but like you've got to do it in a way that works to your brand. So, so 90% of consumers say that authenticity is important when deciding which brands they like and support. So let's see how we can resonate with our customers. So number one is focus on like the buying motivations of your customers. Like, what is it that why are they buying from you? You know, is this something because of peer pressure that all their friends are buying? Perhaps they want, it's an like, aspirational product that you're selling that they really want to become their best self. Are you like selling something that's really based on like fear or pain? And they're trying to solve like a very specific problem. You know, it could be someone's only buying your product because they want to save money and yours is the cheapest. If you're selling a health product, you know, the motivation I think that people want to know is like, does this product actually work? And then they're going to buy it. So that's also really important. Impulse buy is another reason people buy products. Pleasure, you know, just to elevate their lifestyle, like nice smelling candles or, bath bombs. Those are not exactly what you call health or fear or pain, but they're definitely like a way to create more pleasure in your life or an immediate need. So if someone has an emergency, let's say they need a certain type of medication or allergy meds or something like that, or their kid has some kind of dress up day in school tomorrow, they need to buy a costume because it could be an emergency that someone's buying your product. So when you understand the reason why someone is buying your product, then you're much more likely to create messaging that resonates with them because you're understanding where they are in their journey and why they're buying from you. So that's number one. Okay, so let's just address also some potential concerns that people might have. Like, you know, really pricing your products in the right way is very important because it's one of the concerns a lot of people have. They might not buy your product because the price is too high or maybe the price is too low for them. Quality. So if you look the same as everyone else, you need to figure out how to differentiate yourself, okay? So the product itself, like, does it even do what I need? So I've seen this happen a lot when I'm shopping online. I'm looking at, let's say, a USB mic for, you know, doing podcasts like this or YouTube videos. And I don't even know if it does what I need it to do, which is connect with my laptop without needing to use headphones also and without needing extra cables, etc. And people don't even communicate this type of, you know, concern that I might have in their A plus content or in their bullet points on Amazon or on their website even. Potential flaws, you know, let's say your product doesn't do X, Y, and Z like your competitors. So perhaps you can address that and even spin it in a way that it's not even a flaw. You know, where is it sourced? I think nowadays a lot of concerns of buyers are, is your product made in China or is it made in the USA or is it made in some other country? People do like to know where their products are being made. You know, how long are shipping times? That's more for if you're doing, fulfilled by merchant versus, you know, FBA, which is obviously going to be faster. Or if you're shipping from your own website, make sure people know how fast your shipping times are because those are the type of things that concern them. Okay, number three is a great way to resonate and to really, you know, connect with customers and build up that trust is to talk in their voice. So I need everyone to become creepy stalkers. I'm kidding. But what we can do is social media listening. So this is actually super interesting. It's when you can identify your target audience, like you know who they are, you know that your target audience are people who make, let's say millennials who make podcasts. So you need to figure out where are they hanging out? Like where are they discussing their issues or, you know, plans for making their podcast. So it could be they're on Facebook, it could be they're on Instagram or Clubhouse or any of these other things. And then search for those hashtags or conversations or influencers who are people who are, you know, really influencing other people's buying decisions and see what they're talking about. And then what you can do is act on those insights that you've gathered and create content that resonates with the audience because you can see on social media what people are talking about, what problems they've had with other mics in the past, and then use that, you know, to really create more trust and show customers that you have the right product for them. So I think that is really, really important. And yeah, it sounds a bit creepy, like going on social media and like listening to what people are saying, but it's a really great way to gather intelligence, I would say. So here's just like an example. Like I went on like a group called Video Marketing for Entrepreneurs and people are asking like, I need to buy a microphone that attaches to my clothes that will record audio while I film yoga. So if you are selling a mic, like perhaps you can even create like a sub niche and that you really focus on people who are filming yoga videos and show how it's a really good mic for that purpose. Or for instance, this person in the voice acting club, I found you can actually just view posts without even joining Facebook groups. They wrote that the quality of their mic got fuzzy. So maybe you can say on your listings that, you know, even after years and years of use, the audio quality won't get fuzzy and it will stay, you know, really, really high quality and sharp, etc. So those are just, and you could see it even has 32 comments on this post. So you can even see what other people are saying and commenting as well. Okay, now for the good part everyone actually came here for, which is the UGC stuff. Okay, so user generated content. Now, what are the benefits of UGC? So it's going to be instant trust because it's like much more authentic marketing than anything else that you can put out there. And it also shows how you value your customers, which is a super interesting sort of side effect because people do like to be in the spotlight. They do like sharing pictures of themselves online. They like sharing their life. They like sharing what they're doing. And again, with the authenticity, it's just you're showing real people and real faces, and people see people like themselves using your product. They're going to be much more interested in buying it because they see that, you know, other people are doing it and they don't have to be the first one to kind of try this out, basically. So the thing is that the meaning of UGC has kind of changed over the last, like, I would say, couple of years. Now, the original sort of meaning was that brands would encourage or incentivize or even just collect sort of like hashtags or photos that customers were posting of themselves online. So that was the original thing where your actual customers were posting content and then the brands would then reuse that for their own marketing purposes, obviously like with permission. Nowadays though, if you're not aware, is that most brands are actually paying creators to purposefully make videos for their brands and for their products. Because when you're sort of waiting around for your customers to share that, you know, organic type of content, it could take a long time. And what a lot of brands like to do nowadays is hire actors, hire people who are like, this is what they do, this is their job. They send their products to them, they make sort of a what looks like an authentic video or a test sort of testimonial or show them using it in their life. And then they use that video to create ads, to post on TikTok, to post on their Amazon listings in different places. So it's definitely like a much shorter route to getting what looks like user-generated content. So I think that people should really keep that in mind, especially if brands are like, if some store owners are not aware that you can actually pay creators to make videos for you and are wondering how other brands are gathering so much amazing content, it's because they're actually paying people to do that for them. So if you're going for like the long-term game where you really want that organic, authentic, user-generated content that comes from your customers, so there are different ways you can do that. Number one is an insert, you know, getting people, like ask people to use your hashtag. You can even offer some sort of like incentive for using your hashtag, like we'll feature you on our Instagram account or something, or we'll give you a discount, whatever it might be. A web page on your website, which could ask people for photo submissions, and then you can obviously offer them an incentive for that as well. Running contests or challenges is a really fun way to get people engaged with your brand online and generate a lot of content at once, especially if you know if you do have sort of like a big following and people are interested in this contest or challenge that you're running. It works really well for like health brands, or you know, I've seen brands doing like a dry January challenge, and people like to get involved with that. You can also run like campaigns, but you know, when you run a campaign, you really need to make sure that like what you're offering is proportionate to the effort involved in like the people creating the content for you. Okay, so here's just an example from a brand called Buffy, which sells like all kinds of sheets and duvets and pillows and all that fun stuff. So their challenge that they posted online was sleep naked for 7 days and be transformed. And they wrote one in, tag at Buffy and hashtag in the buff on your Instagram post, story or reels, for a chance to be featured on our social or email channels. Now, that's not even like the best incentive to post like something like that you're doing this challenge, but I guess people really like attention, so it worked really well for Buffy. There are other like examples of brands like that. Sorry, I'm just gonna go back a second. Like Starbucks, for instance, did like a white cup challenge where they had like a cup that people could color on and then post on social media or on Twitter and get featured for their artwork on the cups. And that was just a really fun idea also. So you can also, that's sort of like the shorter route, like I said. I mean, the long-term, you know, way of doing UGC, or you can pay to play the UGC game. So option one is that you can actually search for content creators yourself on Twitter, YouTube, Facebook, Instagram, TikTok. But when you're searching for content creators, like you should really look at the type of videos they've made in the past and see, is it even applicable for your brand? Do they, I guess, have the right vibe? Do they have the right accent? Do they have the right aesthetic, you know, wherever they are creating their videos? Option two is posting a job on places like Upwork or even on Fiverr. There are people who are content creators and they will be more than happy to make a video for you that you can put on your Amazon listing. Now, option three is where you can actually use an agency. There are different agencies that create sort of the full strategy for you, where they're not just like, you know, you're not just hiring someone for like $50 to create a video for you. They're going to create a whole strategy for your content. They're going to create multiple UGC ads. They're going to hire the best actors for you. And then you can sort of reuse that content again and again and again for your ads that you might be running on TikTok or Instagram or wherever. So obviously option three is gonna be the most expensive, but it might actually get you really, really good results if you have the budget for that. Okay, so now let's look at some examples of UGC content on Amazon.
And while you're preparing the examples, I wanted to mention to everyone that if you enjoy the content so far, don't forget to like and subscribe below the video. If you have questions, ask those questions in the chat box or in the comment section and you will be answered.
All right, so this is actually not the greatest example, but I thought it was kind of cute because they've put together, this is a brand selling some kind of baby product. I can't even I'm not sure what the brand is, but I cut it off on the screenshot. But it was very sweet because they have different pictures of moms and babies and stuff. And it could be that these photos are literally just stock photos. I'm not sure, but I thought it's a great way of really sort of showing that, you know, if they had the actual products in the pictures, that would be even better. But like one of my clients was doing that. I just know they don't like when I share their content. So that's why I had to find like some other examples from Amazon. But, you know, just showing real life humans that are using a product is a great way of building trust. So this is from the A+ content. Here's, we missed that one. Here's another example. This is actually from a brand called Hers. So this type of UGC is, this is from Instagram actually, but they could totally post this if they had like Amazon listings. Maybe they do have Amazon listings. It's showing like the before and after. Before and after like user photos are super powerful because look how authentic this is. And I've seen so many skincare brands like showing like before and after that is clearly photoshopped and you're like, look how amazing my skin is, and it's like absolutely flawless and not real. Like this is super realistic because you can see like the actual before and after of her skin. Like it's not completely flawless like in month two, but like it's better than it was in month zero. So I thought that was a great example. And okay, this one is from a doggy brand. I actually, you know, Augustus, it took me a while to find like brands that were had some good UGC content on their listing. So I think it's something that's really untapped and people aren't taking enough advantage of because it's pretty easy to get this kind of content, especially if you use some of the strategies that I mentioned before. So this says pick from our buyer and they've got two cute little dogs over here with the dog coat on, which is adorable. And you could see it's like a really realistic picture of someone's dogs by their front door ready to go out for a walk. And here they have on their A+ content even more pictures. And this brand, I have to say, like, well done. They're doing something right. They've got these great pictures showing the dogs wearing all the different sizes of their dog coats. They've got the extra large, the small, and they're showing you how it looks in real life, not just sort of 3D rendered or fake stock photos that have been photoshopped with the, you know, the dog coats on it. So that was a really great example as well. Let's see what's next. Okay, Snow is a brand that sells this special like blue, I don't know if it's like LED or something, I don't know. It's like a special teeth whitening kit. And they've actually basically built their brand on user generated content. And this is from their A+, where they've got pictures of different people using this device in their mouth. You've got people in bed, people outside, people at home. And you can see these are like real faces, all different types of people. So I think it really resonates. Yeah.
It looks very weird, this product.
It looks very strange. I know. Apparently they make a lot of money though. So, and supposedly it really works and it does make your teeth whiter. Yeah, I'm not sure how, but I might be willing to try it. I don't know. Let's see what else we have. Okay, this is from Yeti, I think. And just the style of this image was, I don't know if it's necessarily a user-generated image, but the style of the photo is not like perfectly posed in a studio or a 3D rendered. They've got like a guy driving and then they have the slogan, rough roads are no longer the enemy. And you can instantly understand through the copy what they're talking about, which means that your cup of coffee is not going to spill while you're driving on a bumpy road. And I thought that was like a really awesome way to show a benefit of a product without kind of like saying it out loud, like and point like making like a boring infographic. Like here we're seeing a dude who looks just like a regular guy driving his car and enjoying a cup of coffee along the way. So that was really cool. Let's see what else we have here. Okay, so I'm gonna actually go into this link. Let's see if it works. Can you see my screen still?
Yes, of
course. Okay, so we're on Amazon right now. I'm gonna scroll down. I hope the video is still there. So this video that I saw is not actually on the A+ content. It's below. Let's have a look. I think this might be it. where they have this woman and she goes around in the street with their protein bars and asks people what they think of it. So we can watch for like a few seconds.
By the way, we don't see the video.
We don't see the video. Okay, so I'll explain the video then, because I kind of wanted people to see it, but
we see just your slide. I don't know where.
Oh, okay, fine. So the video, okay. So the video itself is basically like they have a woman, just like this, I don't know, normal woman holding like a tray of these protein bites, and she goes around to people on the street and asks them what they think. So I thought that was actually a really sort of interesting strategy of UGC content, because it's super authentic, because it's not, it doesn't look planned. She's literally going up to random strangers and asking them to try the protein bite without telling them that it's healthy and without telling them it's protein. And then afterwards she says, would you believe me if I said that there was, you know, X, Y, and Z healthy ingredients? And they were like, no, no way. It tastes so good. Like, this is amazing. So I think that's a really authentic way of showing your product in real life, is really just, you can go up to random people on the street, especially if you have a food product, and ask them, like, what do you think of this? You want to try some? And film them, you know, saying what they think. And then if you need to, edit out the people who say it's disgusting. So, yeah, that's just one example. And I hope that we'll be able to watch this video. Let's see.
Hang on. For a long time, I'd been struggling with my weight. I was trying to establish.
Do you see the video, Augustus?
Yes.
Okay. Is it? And do you hear any hear of the this, audio?
Yes, we hear.
Okay.
Teen. I signed up for salsa classes. I felt so awkward. I didn't like how I looked. I wanted something that could easily be incorporated into my lifestyle. I was looking at other pills. None of them were FDA approved. Since I started taking Ally, I lost weight and I feel amazing. Now I can dance the way I really wanted to.
Okay. So I'm gonna stop sharing a minute. Yeah, so you get the point with that video on the A+ premium A+ content. It's a great place that people can take advantage of using a video that really sort of showcases an authentic person. Like, that woman was probably a paid actress who was dancing and saying how amazing it is and it fits in with her lifestyle, but it just, the way that she speaks and the script that they've given her, and the whole sort of flow of the video, like showing it in her bag and that she's dancing and that she's lost weight and now she can dance how she wants to, it was just all like planned amazingly well, as opposed to like, look at this product that I bought, like my life has changed, you should try it too. So that kind of video is a little bit boring, but the way that they did that, they probably paid a lot of money for it, really, really works well. And the A+ premium content is a great place to add those type of videos into your listings. So yeah, that's really all I have in terms of the presentation. I do actually have a download that I put together. If people want it, they can email me and I will send it directly to them. And in the download, I actually give you a basic sort of script that you can work with when you're working with a creator. Like, let's say you don't want to go to an agency, but you want to find your own creator by searching on Facebook or YouTube, wherever it is. And some people need a lot of direction, so I have a script in there. And there's also some other links to sort of cheaper options and platforms that have that help you connect with creators who can make really, really amazing product videos for you that doesn't cost so much money. And then obviously, if you really want to, you know, pay a lot of money, you can go down like the whole full service agency route, depending on how big your business is. Yeah.
And you said to they can send you an email. What is the email?
Yeah, address? Yeah. Just send me. It's info@ecomcopywriter.com. Yeah,
okay,
that's it.
I'm displaying
on
this
screen.
Ecomcopywriter.com.
Yeah.
All right. Perfect. So
I didn't have time to get it up on my website as like a download. So I'm sorry. It's just a nice PDF document, but I'm happy to send it to people because it has some just useful stuff that I've said in the presentation and also other links to really useful platforms.
And we have a really good question. UGC, is it an agency?
No, Yeah, go on. It stands for user-generated content. That's what we said.
Yeah, I was wondering. Yeah, you said, yeah, user-generated content. And let's see a few more questions we have from the audience. Hey, from Tennessee, I just worked with Sasha and highly recommend you get in touch with her.
Thank you. Hi, Brett.
And Let's see what this viewer is asking. Can you please suggest the best content creating agency who handle all content work for the new listing? Which agencies top aggregators hiring to grow their brands?
Top aggregators are hiring? I can't tell you that. I can tell you that I work one-on-one with a lot of clients on their copywriting. And then I also partner with other agencies or freelancers who do the design work. And he can email me if he wants to ask, and I'll send him some links to some agencies.
All right, question from Annabella. For Fiverr and Upwork, do they make unboxing type of videos?
Yeah, I'm sure there are creators that specialize in unboxing videos, for sure. There are people who are really good at that.
All right, another question. How to deter which design content have the best conversion?
Are we talking about UGC content have the best conversion? So I would say that's a great question. It really depends on your overall brand strategy. You know, like what kind of messaging are you putting out there? Are you more formal, casual? Let's say the dog brand, they're selling really well, but their content was really not very professionally put together. I would say, really try and keep things cohesive in terms of your brand colors, your fonts that you're using, the type of tone of voice and messaging that you're putting out there. So those will usually help you have good conversions, and also keeping things simple and focusing on, like we said at the beginning, the buying motivation. Like, why are they buying your product? What are their concerns? You know, what type of things are they looking for? And then the social media listening, like when you really understand what they need from your product, then you're going to be able to put out content that helps people, you know, realize that your product is the one they want and hopefully increase your conversions.
And the same viewer is challenging you. Can you share top 5 hacks for Amazon sellers in 2023?
Oh, goodness. Okay. I don't like hacks. I'm not like a... I like brands who do things properly. That's number one. But I would say like a good... I don't know if it's a hack, but like... for 2023. I don't know. Has a lot changed since 2022? I'm not sure. Maybe it has. But I've seen a lot of people saying that PPC is not necessarily the best way to go in terms of generating more conversions for your listing. And it's worth exploring driving external traffic to your listing. So that could be through UGC ads on TikTok or on Instagram. Posts, Amazon posts, a lot of people still are not using them. And it's amazing because they stay up there for like ever. This was posted like 5 months ago. It's like you just see posts from brands on Amazon, and it's a really authentic place to share UGC content as well. I don't know if I can say 5 off the top of my head, but what else would I say? Cohesive branding. Like, please try and get all your listing photos in the main section of your listing and your A+ content just looking really nice and cohesive in the design. And I don't know, I think that's it for now. I can't come up with 5 on the spot.
I thought maybe there was a typo. Maybe the person meant top 5 hats. Maybe they wanted to know your 5 top colors of the hats. Okay. All right. Can you... let me activate this question. Can UGC improve the listing visibility and search ranking, do you think?
I have no idea. It's a great question. Honestly, you can use Amazon experiments and you can create like an A+ content without UGC and then create an A+ content with a UGC video that you maybe you've paid a creator to make for you and see how that does in terms of your visibility and ranking. Yeah, you never know.
And do you have any idea how we can encourage customers to leave the reviews and provide UGC content for products?
Yeah, that's a great question. I mean, I guess like trying to incentivize your customers is a great way. You do see a lot of brands that have underneath their listing, like in sort of before the review section, there are like all those videos from customers showing the product. Some of them have been like paid, some of them might be part of the Vine program, some of them might have been incentivized by getting a discount from the brand or something like that. So having really like, if you have like an insert that leads, you know, that you have a QR code on it that gets people to then leave their contact details with you and communicate with you is gives you more leverage in terms of really connecting with them. Whereas like if you don't have any way to communicate with your customers after they've purchased, it's much harder for them, for you to then get them to leave a review. But if you're strategic about the type of inserts that you create and the incentives that you can provide them, you're much more likely, I think, to get reviews and UGC content. If you encourage people to, you know, share your hashtag or share photos of themselves on social media, and then there are tools that you can use that really collect and aggregate all of your content, and then you can reuse that online.
And when you work with your clients and you work, of course, on Ableus content, how do you kind of integrate this UGC in the Ableus content? Are you asking the customer to talk to clients, I mean, to your Amazon seller customer, to ask that he asks clients to provide certain specific pictures?
I don't do that. I mean, a lot of the clients I work with are already aware of like using UGC content, and they are purposefully working with creators to get content for their Amazon listings. Like, but if somebody wanted like my advice or of where to put it, like into the A+ content or whether they should use it in the premium A+ content, so I would, you know, advise them based on sort of like their overall brand strategy and messaging and whether it would work for their product. Like some products, I just don't think it's necessary. Like we said, if it's just an impulse buy or an immediate need, like maybe you don't need UGC content, but like we saw with that woman that was the dancer, like it's a supplement product that helps you lose weight. So that's the kind of product that needs somebody talking, like a real person that has like authenticity. Yeah. That was a good question.
Yeah. And let me check a few more questions if we have. No, really. Someone says again, our viewer says, we love Orange Click. Your guy is the best.
Woohoo.
And Josef is asking, do you have any discount for your courses?
Yes, he can email me and I'm happy to give discounts to people who need, for sure.
And the email is info@ecomcopywriter.com. All right. Okay, what else we have here? Do you think
I want to just say like the download that I created, I think it's going to be really, really helpful for people, just that because when you watch a YouTube video, you don't always remember everything I said. So the download I have is actually pretty much a summary with like a whole bunch of extra content and useful stuff for people. So I highly recommend that whoever's watching and wants that download, that they email me and I'll definitely send that to them as soon as possible. Yeah.
Perfect. And do you have an idea how we can measure UGC performance? You mentioned to run A/B tests.
Amazon experiments, yeah.
You think it's the only way?
That is one good way. Also, I think using, let's say, PicFu could be a good way to see if it resonates with people. Because some UGC content just comes across as like a little bit too scripted and people see through it. So I think one of the best ways is to really try and keep the script or like the storyline as authentic as possible. And yeah. I think that's, you know, Amazon experiments is really the best way, because then you're getting like a really alive results, which of your, you know, content is working better and creating more conversions for you.
All right. So again, if you like the content, you liked the tips, don't forget to
subscribe
and like. We still have these features below the video player, so while we still have them, don't forget to use them. And Sasha, before we end, we have a question from
another
Rich.
Question. Okay. I love question... the question part, by the way. When I just speak and do my presentations, I wish people would interrupt me in the middle. That would be more fun. Mm.
Well, you speak without a break, so we cannot interrupt you.
Oh, I'm sorry.
You have to improve. So Rich wants to know, if the UGC user-generated content is a video, can you track video engagement on Amazon?
Can you track video engagement?
Once you,
I don't think you can track specifically what people are clicking on or viewing. I think you can track how much traffic is going to your listing, but I don't think you can track how many views it has. Like you can do that on social media for sure, but I don't think Amazon gives you that. I might be wrong, but as far as I know, I don't think you can actually track like the video engagement. I think you can see on posts, if you use Amazon Posts, it does give you some data on how many people have sort of viewed that content. And you can also schedule that stuff to go out. But yeah, the actual videos that are on your listing or on your A plus premium content, you can't really track. Yeah. That's a great idea, Rich. You should suggest that to Amazon themselves. Yeah. They should implement that as a feature.
And it's important to note that your specialization is to write content, right? To copyright.
Correct. I'm a copywriter, that is what I specialize in. And I just also enjoy the whole strategy that goes into people's products, because there's so much more than just like me writing an Amazon listing. There's a lot of work that goes into building up brands online, and having like a full holistic strategy is what's really working. Like I think that with UGC especially, like if you just have that one video that you posted on your Amazon listing, like that's nice, but if you can actually do the long-term strategy where you're really getting customers engaged with your brand online, so it's not just on the Amazon listing, it's really like across all your content on your website or on your social media channels, or have content, like a whole bunch of content that you can run ads with and then drive that traffic to your listing, it's going to be a lot more successful than just having that like one video campaign or one picture or whatever, a bunch of pictures that you got from your customers. Although that is a good start, I just think that there's so much more that people can do with UGC.
Great. One of the last questions. Greg wants to know, what strategies do you use to evaluate and select content creators for social media UGC? Do you lean into data-driven metrics like demographics?
Yeah, so that's a great question. The thing with UGC content creators, like how do you evaluate and select them? So we need to understand that people who are creating UGC content are not influencers. They don't have a following on social media. Although some UGC content creators will post organically to their social media handles, it's not necessarily like what they do. On the other hand, you have people who are influencers who you would pick based on the success of their previous content on their on their Instagram or on their TikTok, and seeing if it's the right type of influencer for your brand. Like, are they actually, let's say, into a natural and healthy lifestyle, if that's the type of product that you're selling? But in terms of actually evaluating content creators, like this is actually in the download that I have, like a sort of mini checklist that you can do, is like the location they're in, make sure the lighting and like the videos, the quality, like get them to send you samples of stuff they've already created to see if they can actually create high quality content for you. Do they know what they're doing? Can they edit the videos? Are they going to do post-production stuff, or will you have to do that yourself? So those are the type of things that you want to sort of ask them beforehand. Like, are they going to write their own script, or do they want you to provide the script? And those are really important details, yeah, that you need to evaluate before you kind of select the creator and jump into it, you know, without thinking about it. Yeah.
Perfect. So one more time, how do you help Amazon sellers? All the links from Sacha you'll find below in the description.
Yes. Oh, you want me to say one more time what I do?
Yes, in six words.
Okay, six words. Sacha brings the magic and meaning to your products and helps you connect authentically with your customers.
More than six words.
Sorry.
Perfect. Yeah. So also, if you want more content from Sacha, check. We should have a playlist or some links to previous webinars.
I have been on this channel.
Yeah, many times. And if you are in Israel, maybe you can meet her in one of the, I don't know, Amazon meetups if something is happening like this.
Maybe.
All right. Thank you very much.
Stuff happening. All right. Thanks, Augustus.
Thank you.
Bye.
Bye-bye.